As we solve the problem of CMOS NOR2 gate in last video, in this video we are going to verify the calculated value in last videos on Multisim simulation. So let's do. Open the Multisim. Now we have to make the CMOS NOR2 circuit. For that we have to take the component. So for components, go in place, click on component, go in group and select all group. Here in search, select search for MOS, click on MOSian, click on OK, place MOS transistor. Now take another NMOS transistor, click on OK, place here. Now take one MOSP transistor, place it here. Now take the MOSP 4 terminal transistor, click on OK. Now take search for VDD, click on OK, place VDD. Now search for DC power source, so here is the DC power, click on OK. Now take ground, click on OK. Close this window. Now first of all we have to flip these two PMOS transistors. For that click on right click on the transistor, and in this window click on flip vertical, sim for second PMOS, flip vertical. Now we have to join the all transistor together according to circuit diagram. So follow the steps, join this terminal to the drain terminal of first NMOS transistor and this to this, connect this source terminal together and connect to ground. Now connect the gate terminal of the NMOS transistor to the power supply, positive of the power supply, connect negative to the ground. Now connect VDD to the source terminal of the PMOS transistor and connect the source terminal of the second PMOS transistor to the VDD. Now connect gate terminal of the first PMOS transistor to the first NMOS transistor. So I am going to connect. So here is the gate terminal, and gate terminal of the second to the gate terminal of second NMOS transistor. Now give power supply to second NMOS transistor. So here is the power supply connection. So connect it to second NMOS transistor. Now here is our output. Now for checking the output, we have to place the probes on the output side. For taking probes, go in place, click on probe, take voltage probe. This is our output side, so place it anywhere in this connection. So I am going to place here. Rename it as VOUT1, click on OK. Rename this also as VIN, and VIN is 0 volt, and click on label and change it into VIN, click on OK. Now we have to also see the current levels. For that take a current probe, again go in place, go in probe, and in probe take current probe and place over it, change its label also. So here is the, this is our IC short circuit current, click on OK. Now this is our circuit diagram of CMOS NOR2 gate. Now we have to see the graph. For that go in simulation, go in analysis and simulation. So in this video, going DC switch, change VDD to Vin. Our start value is 0 and stop value is 5 as our VDD is 5 and increment is 0.01. Now click on output here. Add ISC and Vout 1 is by default added in this. Now click on run, so you will get this curve, but we don't set the parameters of PMOS and NMOS, so we get this curve. Now we have to set the parameters as per given here. W by L ratio of PMOS transistor is 4. We have to set that first. So these are the two PMOS transistors. For setting parameters, double click on transistor. So here you can click on value, and here is the W by L ratio. So make W is 400. So W by L will be 4. And now for PMOS P transistor, transconductance is 20 micro and threshold voltage is minus 0.7, so we have to set that also. So for that, go in edit module. In edit module, you can see here is a transconductance which is 20 micro, make it as 20 micro into 10 to the 2 minus 6, and threshold voltage is minus 0.7. So now click on change components, click on OK. Now similar for second PMOS transistor, WC W by ratio 400, and it will be W by ratio will be 4. Now for setting transconductance and threshold voltage, click on edit model. Here you can see transconductance, make it as 20 as previous view, minus 6, 20 10 is to minus 6, and threshold voltage is minus 0.7. Click on change component and click on OK. Now we have to set the parameters of NMOS transistors. For NMOS, W by L ratio is 1, so let's set that. Double click on NMOS transistor, and here is the W by L. 1 is by default. Now we have to set the transconductance, that is 40 micro, and VTN is 0.7, so we have to set that. For that, go in edit module. So transconductance is 40 micro, therefore make it as 40 into micro is 10 to minus 6, and threshold voltage is 0.7. click on change component. Similarly for second NMOS transistor, W L ratio is 1 by default. Click on edit model, double click on transconductance parameter, set it as 40 micro into 10 raised to minus 6, and threshold voltage is 0.7. click on change component, click on OK. So this is all parameters are set, and now we have to check our curve again. So go in simulation. In simulation, go in analysis of simulation. Now we have done all the settings here, just we have to run, so we will get this curve. Now we have to check the values. So for that, we require cursor. For cursor, go click on cursor, click on show cursor. So take first cursor, now when VIL is 1.65, Vout is 4.6. so let's see, when VIL is 1.65, here you can see the VIL and here you can see Vout. So make it as 1.65. So here you can see that VIL is 1.65 and output, we get output 4.6, which is exactly equals to the calculated. Now let's see VIH and its output. So when VIH is 2.5, we get Vout 0.4. So let's say 2.5, so make it as 2.5. When 2.5, we get 0.516 volt, and we have calculated 0.45, which is approximately equal. Now for the see the levels of IC, we have to do some modification. Go in graph, this is our IC curve, but it is not exactly correct. For that, go in graph, click on properties, here click on trace. So for our IEC, we should take the right axis. So here in Y vertical axis, click on right axis, and for second, our Vout, Vout 1, we have taken left axis, it is by default. And now left axis or voltage axis, so make it a change the label into Vout only. Click on auto range here, and for bottom axis is our input voltage axis. So change the label into Vin. Click on auto range, and our right axis is the short circuit current. So make it as IEC. First of all, enable it. Don't forget to enable it. Click on auto range and click on apply. Then again you have to make it is auto range, and then click on apply. Then only you can get. Click on apply and click on OK. So this is, we get the, so here ISC is 44, but it is not equal. So we have done one mistake. Change this probe here, because here IEC is divided into two part, and we have to keep probe on the drain terminal of the second NMOS transistor. Now check our IEC, what we get. So now we get exactly equal 88 for 2.19. when VTH is 2.19, we get IEC 88. So this is how all parameters are exactly equal to calculated values. So thank you.